This day glow orange jacket is by 70s and 80s designer Stephen Sprouse, so that's my era, unlike some of the other designers I collect, including Ozzie Clark. In the 80s, we wore things big and boxy, so while I'm always looking for vintage Sprouse pieces, they can be very hard to wear. We felt very beautiful in them back in the day, but now a lot of times things need a lot of alterations. Back in the day, I had one big boxy Sprouse piece of my own, which was a white jacket that I got for a summer job, and it became so discolored that I couldn't save it. So any Sprouse pieces I have now, any clothing pieces I've gotten from eBay or vintage stores over the past, say, 15 years. Stephen Sprouse tended to have a hard time staying in business, unfortunately, and he kind of went in and out of business. But he had a comeback around 2000 when he did a collaboration with Louis Vuitton on kind of graffiti handbags, and I was desperate to get one, and I did. Stephen Sprouse unfortunately died of lung cancer in 2004, and he made, despite that, he made another comeback with Vuitton in 2009 when they did another series of work inspired by him. But I didn't get any of that because it just made me sad. Stephen Sprouse means a lot to me because he was probably one of the first high fashion designers I was ever aware of, and that's because of his work with Debbie Harry, the lead singer of Blondie. They were good friends, and he styled her all the time. And the first time I saw Blondie was for their 1978 video, Heart of Glass. And tell me who is more beautiful than that woman. I was about 10 at the time, and I completely had a crush on her. The dress that Debbie Harry is wearing in the Heart of Glass video is by Sprouse, of course. It's asymmetric with one strap. And the print is kind of pixelated lines from a television screen blown up a million times. And I would wear that dress today. I'm obsessed with that dress. And Debbie, if you still have that dress, please call me. Let's talk. Blondie came up in a weird way on social media recently, where some random fool said that Blondie's 1980s song Rapture was the first rap song ever. It was the first number one song that had any rap lyrics in it, but it wasn't even the first rap hit. And like, come on, if you listen to the lyrics, she shouts out rap pioneers Fab Five Freddy and Grandmaster Flash. So it's right in the lyrics that she's paying tribute to the people who came before her. Funnily enough, within days of that conversation, Google put out a really good doodle that celebrated the 44th anniversary of rap. They put it back to August 1973. So there you have it. Rapture is a great song, a great pop song, kind of a disco song, and it has a funny rap in it, but it was not the first rap song by any means. I didn't first hear rap in 1973. The first rap song I heard was Rapper's Delight by Sugar Hill Gang, which came out in 1979, so a year before Blondie's song. And that was a huge hit too. I don't think it made it to number one on Billboard, but it was a big hit on the radio everywhere. But then, of course, you know, I did have this major crush on Debbie Harry, so anything that they put out, I was just a big Blondie fan no matter what, but, you know, so Rapture could have been any kind of song and I would have liked it, but happened to be one of the early pop rap crossovers, and I still remember, and you get in your car and you drive really far and you drive all night, and then you see a light and it comes right down and it lands on the ground and out comes the man from Mars. I can actually do the entire rap, but I have to admit I stumble over the first few lines, which the ones that mention Freddy and Grandmaster Flash, so I don't want to disrespect them by being all tongue-tied. And then I respect you all too much to just force you to listen to the whole thing. But in the meantime, when you're listening to it yourself online or wherever, streaming, you can also check out my blog through the links below this video for pictures of me wearing my Stephen Sprouse pieces. In addition to this jacket, I also have two skirts. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel so you don't miss the next video. 15 years. Oh my God. Run, but he's got a gun and he shoots you dead and he eats your head, and then you're in the man from Mars. You go out at night eating cars, you eat Cadillacs, Lincolns too, Mercurys and Subarus. Thank you very much, Erin.